My current cell phone isn't broken, but I'll change it anyway when a new version comes out. The gift looks much better in fancy packaging. The table setting should be visually rich. Oh, you can't finish your food? Then you can just throw it away. How did you feel when you heard those phrases? If you felt a little unpleasant or questioned what was said, you're probably thinking eco-friendly. If you feel uncomfortable with excessive waste disposal, you are ready to practice zero waste. So what is zero waste? Zero waste refers to the principle of waste prevention while processing, producing, and using a product. Trying to use one product for as long as possible, avoiding excessive packaging and disposable use, not leaving leftover food or throwing them away. Recycling, reusing, and recovering are all efforts to make zero waste. How did this zero waste come to be? In the early 2000s, environmental pollution caused by overflowing garbage became an international problem. People have noticed that the current industrial system that leads to mass production, mass consumption, mass destruction is the main culprit for the Earth's disease. The amount of garbage discharged per day is about 50,000 tons and 80 million tons per year. Most of the garbage piled up like this is incinerated or dumped. Smoke from burning garbage pollutes the atmosphere and produces a toxic chemical called dioxin. The landfill emits a strong odor from methane gas and contaminated water generated by the rotting waste. Pollutant water flows into the sea and rivers, which are absorbed into our bodies and harm our health. Also, trash thrown into the sea creates microplastics and garbage islands, causing severe environmental pollution. In the early 2000s, people faced the greatest crisis in human history, global warming, and began to study zero waste to help the environment. First of all, the public took the initiative to share a zero waste method that was simple and practical for individuals, and further strongly demanded change from companies. As a result, companies have also begun to make efforts such as minimal packaging, refraining from using disposable products, and minimizing waste in the production process. American blogger Bee Johnson, who first started the zero waste movement, shared the practice through 5 R's. First is refuse, or to reject unnecessary items. Refuse is not to make unnecessary waste by not using disposable items. Next is reduce, which means reducing the amount spent. It is to minimize unnecessary waste in everyday life. Reuse is to multi-use products. This means that instead of using disposable products, we should reduce waste by purchasing products that can be used several times. Next, recycle is done only when it can't be reused. In other words, if you reuse something and it becomes no longer usable, you can recycle it for other purposes. The recent trend of producing new products by extracting fibers from the plastic can be seen as recycling. Finally, rot is to circulate resources using products that can rot away. Plastic or vinyl remains pollutes to the surrounding environment, including land and the sea. If you use products made of rotting materials such as bamboo and paper, you can circulate naturally without harming the environment. When we practice the 5 R's in our daily lives, we can say that we are joining the zero waste movement. Refuse, reduce, reuse, recycle, and rot. These are the 5 R's to help protect the Earth's environment. Our small practices can add up to create a better Earth without trash.